All right, hey brothers and sisters, God bless each and every single one of you. It's Hunter's Point here with another video. I hope everyone's doing well. Figured I'd come on here and give you all a short three-article update. Nothing too big here. I'm trying to kind of get myself caught up on all the world news because I've been gone 2 to 3 days kind of resting. I've had to take breaks a little bit more often with just all the spiritual attacks that I've been going through. It's significantly ramped up in the past month and a half. So I'm having to take breaks more frequently, but you know what? Whenever I take short, frequent breaks, that's better than me having to take 2 weeks off every now and then. So just short little breaks is usually enough to recharge the batteries. I'm feeling all right this morning. I'm feeling a lot better than I have the past several mornings. So praise God for that. I'm feeling pretty good right now. So I figured I'd come on here, give you all a relatively brief three-article update. So this will be your world news update for the 24th of August, 2020. It's crazy that it's already nearing the end of August. That is just wild. And then you look at everything we've actually seen during the month of August, even going back to last month, just combining all the world news events together. It's just been remarkable. I mean, I was telling my buddy Travis this yesterday. It's like everything we're seeing is just crazy, man. It's all ramping up, which just means we're out of here soon. That's the positive news there. But I'm going to go ahead and get into the three articles. All three of them are off of endtimeheadlines.org, so I will get into this first article right now. Prophecy Watch: Iran, Hamas, and Islamic Jihad call for an uprising after the United Arab Emirates and Israeli peace agreement was reached. The coalition of Iran, Hamas, and Islamic Jihad are all calling for a unified uprising in response to the recent UAE-Israel peace deal brought on vis-a-vis the United States of America, or as I call them, the Divided States of America, for obvious reasons. A Palestinian Islamic Jihad's representative to Iran recently stated the following. Quote, "The Middle East needs an uprising similar to the Islamic Revolution in Iran that will unite the resistance of the Islamic community against a culture of defeat, which has affected Arab regimes." Unquote. Meanwhile, in Iran, Mehr News hosted Nasser Abu Sharif of Islamic Jihad, which is backed by Tehran, and emphasized, quote, "the betrayal of the United Arab Emirates in the signing of the peace agreement to normalize relations with, quote, the Zionist enemy," which obviously is referring to Israel in that context. Qaddami said that the agreement has crossed a red line and that Israel is now more secure than in the past. He went on to say that Israel was like, quote, "a criminal running free without anyone to put it on trial," unquote. Sharif went on to point out that when Egypt had signed a peace deal with Israel, the Arab League had suspended Egypt and moved its headquarters temporarily from Cairo. Egypt was readmitted to the Arab League in 1989. "Hamas is outraged," the representative told Iran, quote, "Nations in our educated class have a great responsibility in questioning friendly countries for normalizing relations," unquote. He said that the Zionist regime is an enemy and will remain an enemy, unquote. Again, referring to Israel and nations surrounding Israel. "The destiny of the Zionist regime is destruction and decay, and whoever has a relationship with it will be transferred to the dustbin of history," unquote, once again by those Iranian officials. "Is this yet more stepping stones to bring about Bible prophecy? In the book of Psalms, chapter 83, the Bible mentions a coalition of Islamic nations that will come together in an attempt to destroy Israel. Are we seeing the beginning of this event? Are we seeing the sort of the building up, the foundation being laid, if you will, for this event eventually unfolding in the days ahead?" Something worth thinking about. That's that first article. Second article, this one's a bit sad, but this is something that's just happened. Twin bombings in the South Philippines leaves 14 killed and 75 wounded. A series of attacks in the Philippines has left scores injured and at least 14 dead. According to CBN, Muslim militants, along with the Islamic State, triggered a powerful motorcycle explosive followed by a suicide bombing on Monday, killing many soldiers. The attack is deemed the worst extremist attack in the Philippines this year, according to military officials. The attack has left at least 75 soldiers, police officers, and civilians wounded in the bombings that took place in Jolo Town in the southern Sulu province. This attack comes as the government there continues to grapple with the highest number of coronavirus infections in all of Southeast Asia. In more detail of the report, it was stated that most of the victims, including children, were killed and wounded in the first attack when a bomb was reportedly attached to a motorcycle and set off near two parked army trucks in front of a grocery store and a computer shop in Jolo. Quote, it was a vehicle-borne improvised explosive device which exploded while our soldiers were on a marketing run, according to Vin Luen, who had actually told that to reporters. The second blast, which was carried out from a female suicide attacker and took place about an hour after the first attack and killed the bomber, it was a soldier, a police commando, and several others were actually wounded by the second blast. The suspected bomber was said to have walked out of a snack shop, approached soldiers who were securing a Roman Catholic cathedral, and, quote, suddenly blew herself up. Snipers were then deployed in the region to guard against more bombers as the victims were carried out to an ambulance. It was later discovered that a third bomb was reportedly discovered in a public market, but it was never actually detonated. Jolo was immediately placed in a security lockdown by troops and police. So a lot of unfortunate violence going on in the Philippines. Third one, this is relatively significant as far as I'm concerned. Once again, endtimeheadlines.org, where all three articles were found. Shofar may be blown on the Temple Mount for the first time since the destruction of the temple. According to a new report from BIN, which is Breaking Israel News, a petition is currently being considered by Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, which would reportedly permit Jews to blow the shofar on Rosh Hashanah on the Temple Mount, which is the first time that this could happen since the destruction of the temple. This is the first time that a Jew would be granted permission to blow the shofar at the holiest site in the world since the destruction again of the temple. According to the report, the Organization of 70 Nations, which is headed by Rabbi Hillel Weiss, and the Land of the Israel Organization, headed by Aviad Vosali, I hope I pronounced that decently, petitioned Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu to permit the blowing of the shofar on the Temple Mount on the holy day of Rosh Hashanah. Quote, Jews are only permitted to enter the Temple Mount 5 days a week, Sunday to Thursday. This year, the first day of Rosh Hashanah is on Saturday, the Sabbath. According to Jewish law, it is forbidden to blow the shofar on the Sabbath, except for on the Temple Mount. So we submitted a request to permit a group of Jews to do so, to blow the shofar on the Temple Mount on the first day of Rosh Hashanah. Again, quote-unquote, from the people petitioning the Israeli government. If this petition is granted, it will mark the first time a shofar will be blown on the Temple Mount since the destruction of the temple over 1,950 years ago. So I do believe that this is pretty significant. Definitely worth keeping your eyes on Israel and really all the nations within the Middle East. I will give you all the gospel and then I will head out. 1 Corinthians 15, 1-4, Moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preached unto you, which also ye have received and wherein ye stand. I apologize, I'm a bit rusty today. By which also ye are saved, if ye keep in memory what I preached unto you, unless ye have believed in vain. For I delivered unto you first of all that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. It never gets old. Right, that is the gospel, the good news of 1 Corinthians 15, 1-4. That is what saves us if we believe that in our heart. It's that simple. It all revolves around believing on Christ alone. There's no amount of good works that we could ever do that'll earn our way into the kingdom of heaven. Right, it's all about believing Christ's finished redemptive work on the cross at Calvary almost 2,000 years ago. John 3:16 says, For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Verse 17, For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Verse 18, He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Please believe on Jesus Christ if you haven't. I mean, time is so short. That's all you have to do to be saved, is believe that Christ died for all of your sins, was buried, and rose again the third day according to the Scriptures for your justification. Right? We are justified by faith alone in Christ alone. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9, which I'll go to right now, says, For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. Right, so that'll conclude your world news update. I'm still actively battling attacks against the enemy right now. I mean, the fact that I'm on here right now doing a world news update means that I obviously feel a lot better. But I would appreciate if you guys would continue to lift me up in prayer. Your prayers really do work. They're very powerful. And it's a big part of why I'm actually on here today giving this update. Right, so that'll conclude this particular update. I'll see you guys in the next video, should the Lord tarry. Otherwise, God bless.